The brain is built from thousands of different neurons which have to organize themselves together in a functional network and to allow to perceive, organize and store information from external stimuli. So the function of these neuronal networks is dependent on a precise regulation of gene expression. And gene expression is regulated by various mechanisms, but the mechanism we are focusing on is the epigenetic regulation of gene expression. And epigenetic regulators, they are involved in making the genes accessible or inaccessible, depending how they package the DNA. One of the major suppressive marks for gene expression is a methylation of a histone on lysine 9. And the enzymes which are responsible for setting this suppressive mark are the enzymes called GNRNA and GNRNA-like protein, GLP. So GNRNA and GLP, they're expressed in all cells. And to understand their specific role in the brain, we remove them only in the brain. Removal of GNRNA and GLP in postnatal neurons in the mouse brain changes their behavior rather dramatically. What we initially observed is that they didn't move as much as the normal mouse. They didn't explore novel space. They also were not afraid of potentially dangerous environments like a wide open area where a predator could snatch the mouse anytime. They also were not able to learn and memorize new tasks. They became obese and they had problems or they did not respond to positive rewards as expected. They had no preference for sweets, for example. To understand more about the potential mechanism associated with this behavioral abnormalities in these mice, we look now what are the genes which are changing when we remove this gene suppressive mark, this histone methylation mark. And what we found is that, as you would expect from removing a suppressive mark, we see a lot of genes now being upregulated in the brain, and many of them are genes which are normally not expressed in the brain. Genes which are usually expressed in the heart or in skeletal muscle or in the immune system. So that led us to the conclusion that this suppressive histone mark actually helps to maintain the neuronal identity by preventing genes which are usually expressed in other organs but not in the brain, being expressed in the brain. The same proteins, the GNRNA-GLP complex, which we manipulated in mice, has been recently linked to a very severe human mental retardation syndrome. And the syndrome is characterized by mental retardation, learning disabilities, the development of obesity and apathy, and it's very similar to the symptoms we observe in our mice. And if we are able to identify now specific genes which are responsible in the mouse causing the symptoms, this might be the same genes which are also responsible for the symptoms in humans, which would be very helpful and exciting.